Analysis here. Activity 1. This activity helps you to find HCF of two positive numbers. We first observe the following instructions. Construct a rectangle whose length and breadth are the given numbers. So here they have given 3. Now I have taken 12, 20. I am going to do for 12, 20. I am going to find out the HCF for 12 and 12, 20 with the help of this activity. Try to fill the rectangle using small squares. So just you take a graph sheet like this. It is the better way because they have asked you to fill it with squares. Try with 1 by 1 square. Try with 2 by 2 square. Try with 3 by 3 square and so on. The side of the largest square. This is the answer. The side of the largest square that can fill the whole rectangle without any gap will be HCF of the given number. So, this is the answer. The side of the largest square is the HCF of the given numbers. So, you are going to fill this full rectangle with the squares, 1 by 1 square and 2 by 2 square, 3 by 3 square and so on. The side of the largest square. The side of the largest square. Just let us check 12 and 20. You are going to find out the HCF. Just let me take the square. 1 by 1. 1 by 1. Is it necessary to fill up the 1 by 1? Why they have said that the side of the largest square? Because since it is the graph sheet, it is no need to fill 1 by 1, I think. But for practice, just I am doing how you have to fill it. 1 by 1. Like this, you have to fill it out, each one. So, the whole graph sheet can be filled by 1 square. Do you follow? 1 by 1 square. Like this, you can fill this whole graph sheet. What is it? 20, 12 and 20. This is 20. The length I have taken is as 20. This is 20, you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Here this side, 12. Just you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, how many 1 by 1 square you can fill the whole graph sheet? How many single squares will be there? 240. Because 12 into 20. That is 1 by 1 square. How many 1 by 1 squares can be filled with this whole graph sheet? 240 1 by 1 square. But we want the largest square, isn't it? So this 1 by 1 square, we don't want it. We don't want this 1 by 1 square. Next, what you have to take? 2 by 2 square. Actually, 2 by 2 also, it is not necessary because highest they have said. The side of the largest, isn't it? So let me take the different color. 2 by 2. Let me start here for better understanding. But you try to do it for the whole thing. Because within 20 minutes, I have to finish up this problem. So what is it? 2 by 2. How many squares like this? You have to fill the whole graph sheet. Since it is 1 by 1, I didn't do that, but 2 by 2 just for one column I will do. Do you follow? Similarly, in the same way, you have to fill up the whole graph sheet. Will you be able to do it or not? Since you are small children, just like a game, you try to do it. So, how many 2 by 2 squares can be filled for the whole graph sheet? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Isn't it? 2 by 2. How many? 6. Here, how many you will get? 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just let me fill it up. Then it will be clear for you. Instead of filling up the whole graph sheet, just this rows and columns alone, you can fill it and you can find it out very easily and very fast. Since I am doing the digital pen, it may not be equal squares, but I try to adjust with it. Just you understand the concept, that's all. Here, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here, 6. So, 10 into 6. How many? 62 by 2 squares. How many squares? 2 by 2 squares. 62 by 2 squares can be filled with this whole graph sheet. Next, 3 by 3. While you are taking 3 by 3, is it possible to fill up the whole graph sheet? No. You won't be able to fill it up. You won't be able to fill it up the whole graph sheet. Because 3, 12 is divisible by 3. But 20 is it divisible by 3? No. So 3 by 3 squares, better not to take here. Better not to take. Suppose if you want to check with it, you check it. No problem. If you want to check it, you can check with that. But surely there will be some empty space. There will be some squares. It won't cover the whole graph sheet. There will be a space. So I didn't take 3 by 3. Next one, what I am going to take? 4 by 4. Next one, what I am going to take? 4 by 4. 4 by 4. That means what? 1. I told you row and column, it is better to fill. Then you will be able to understand whether we will be able to cover the whole graph sheet or not. 3. Here it is covered, isn't it? The same way here also. Isn't it? Is it okay or not? For 3 by 3, just you check it. Since I don't find time, I didn't do. Otherwise, that also I could have explained. Just you see. While you are able to fill this rows and columns like this, then the whole graph sheet can be covered with this. Do you follow? So, without remaining. If you want to cover it, then you can do it like this also. Because now I got the answer, I am filling the whole graph sheet. This is the largest square. 1 by 1 we have taken, 2 by 2 we have taken, 3 by 3 also we have taken, but we know that we won't be able to cover the whole graph sheet by 3 by 3. So I didn't do. Next I have chosen 4 by 4. Is it okay? Very interesting. While you are doing the activity, really it is nice to learn. You won't forget the concept till your death. When you are learning through activity, it will be very interesting, and also concept clearance will be there. Now you see how many squares are here. 1, 2, it is not necessary to write like this, isn't it? How can you say that? 5, 3, isn't it? Because 4 by 4, what is it? 4 by 4 you have taken. That means this is divided by 4. What is it? 3. This is divided by 4. What is it? 5. So 3 5s are 15. How many 4 by 4 squares are there? 15 4 by 4 squares are there. So what is the HCF of 12, 20? The HCF is 4. What is the HCF? HCF is 4. Do you follow? Suppose if you want to check with 3 by 3 also, you can do it. You see, whole thing. So, how many members you can make them to sit like this? Equally, 15 members. You can allot it, isn't it? 4 by 4 square. When you draw, in each square, one person can be occupied. So, how many persons there you can make the seating arrangement? For 15 members, while you are taking 4 by 4. Do you follow? Suppose if you are taking 1 by 1, how many members they can be seated? 240. 2 by 2 means 60. Do you follow? Since there is time, just let us check with the 3 by 3. I told you, no, you can't fill up the whole graph sheet with the 3 by 3. Just you can check it. What color shall we take? Yellow. 3 by 3. What I am going to take? 3 by 3. Just you fill it and see. What is it? 3 by 3. I told you, while you are filling up, you go with row and column. 1, 2, 3. Next in the same way. Sorry. One, two, three. It has to come down up to here. Since I'm an aged person, I cannot find out the squares correctly. 3. Isn't it? Here. 3. Here you are getting. But here you see, because this is 20. This is 20. Three, four, 5. Six. You see, is it possible to draw 3 by 3 here? Only 2 are there. Do you follow? Why I didn't select 3 by 3 square? So by seeing the number itself, you will be able to take a type of squares, whether 1 by 1 or 2 by 2 or 3 by 3 or 4 by 4, 5 by 5, like that. But you can go on with this. But according to that, proper square should be selected to fill the graph sheet. Do you follow or not? So 3 by 3, don't want. 3 by 3, it is not necessary to fill the graph sheet. 1 by 1, 2 by 2, next is what is the possibility you have to go? 4 by 4, not 3 by 3. Do you follow? Next, up to 4 you have completed. Next you can go for 5 by 5 also. But 5 by 5 also you can't do. Why? 20 it is divisible. 12 is it divisible? Next 6 by 6. Because they have said largest square. Largest square. Whether you follow, the answer is correct or not, just to check with the help of the problem. Well, what is it? There are 3 methods you have learnt, isn't it? Just repeating subtraction. Repeated subtraction, let us do. 20 minus 12. What is it? 8. Next is 12 minus 8. 4. Next is 8 minus 4. 4. Same numbers have come. So 4 is the HCF. Otherwise, next step you do. 4 minus 4 is 0. So what is the HCF? 4. This is one way of doing. Otherwise, by factorizing method, 20. Just for verification, by through activity, you have learnt it. But with the help of the problem also, just I am recalling. 2, 10, 2, 5. Next one is 12, 2, 6, 2, 3, 2, sir. What are the common thing? 2, 2. So, 2, 2, sir, 4. 4 is the HCF. Do you follow, my dear? So, just you see, they have said that the largest square, I have stopped up to 4 only because I came to know that with the help of 4, I will be able to cover it up. 5 also it is not possible, 6 also it is not possible. So, only 4 by 4 square only, it is the answer for this activity. That is HCF is 4. Do you follow? Thank you. For the next 2 numbers, when I have time, I will do it. Otherwise, you try yourself. But this is, you see, 11, 9. Let me see who is telling the answer for this.